Goodbye.
This is the first time we're leaving you, and I want you to have amazing behavior, okay? We have to go somewhere very important. Wish we could take you, but Gigi's gonna watch you. She's gonna make sure you say your prayers in the morning and get your exercise, okay?
Okay.
And if you need us, send a bat signal. You know what those look like? A bat signal. Call you when it does. Love you, okay?
What's up, guys?
Hey!
Where we at, babe?
We at your home.
New York. What's up?
Yeah, guys, so we just landed in New York. It was so hectic earlier in San Diego, so we couldn't record, but hey, man, we're back on track, taking you on this trip. We're in New York for today. And tomorrow might be in a different location. We'll see.
Welcome to Showcase NYC.
I just started with a name. It's a medium?
No, it's a large.
That's what I was like. I don't think
this is.
Come to Showcase, guys. We're gonna have the address right here, Brooklyn. Yeah, you guys make sure you guys come out to Showcase and show love. They also got kids. All these new colors for kids.
You
can
get more colors,
Yogi. And this is the new design that Yogi got out with. Yeah. Hoodies. Crew necks. Got the caps. Yeah, that's sweet right there. That's sweet. Welcome to Peppers.
You gotta bring them in the town when we pull up.
So, we just left Peppers. Brother Mo in the back. The vibe in Brooklyn. Going through the town. It'd be feeling so good to come back to Brooklyn.
We went through too much.
We in the town, Flatbush. You know what I'm saying? Got Mo in the town right now.
I'm very, my size. No, I'm very familiar.
He's familiar with
this place
over here.
Because you know what? I got a car accident here.
You sure the hell do. Y'all know the vibe, no shit, Ave.
Babe. Hmm? You on the street? Get on the sidewalk, please. Man, show the camera. She's on the street. I'm on the sidewalk, get on the sidewalk.
Yo, he's really, man. I gotta remember who I'm dealing with when I come out here.
You're not a New Yorker anymore, okay?
Definitely a New Yorker, brother man.
Everybody's so nice.
He think everybody's so nice in the town. Yeah, right. What'd you just do, MC, babe? MC, you just did?
Hey, what's up? What up, Richard?
I didn't grow up on these sides, though. I grew up in the 40s, Glenwood side, Junction.
Babe, what are you doing? Chill out.
Chill out, bro.
Man, you trying to get hit.
He don't understand the era.
I understand how color
you. You just gotta go with the flow. The Akis for a sandwich, bacon, egg, and cheese. But no cheese for me.
I want number three.
Imagine that. Where you at, babe?
Bodega.
Just to go to the bodega. Just to go to the bodega.
I'm gonna get a Jamaican cola because I just got some peppers.
Credit.
Yeah, that's a bum juice.
That's a bum juice?
Yeah.
That looks very
bum-ish.
Attractive.
All right, good looking. Thank you.
Hey Alexa. Play Alicia Keys, Concrete Jungle.
Concrete Jungle with dreams of magic. You are slow. Play Concrete Jungle.
Is that not the song?
No, we just talking about New York?
Yeah.
Nah, you supposed to say Alexa. Play some Pop Smoke. That's what he's supposed to say.
Hey Alexa, play Tasha Cobb.
For your glory. Yo, you're annoying. Showing him around. He's been over here before, but we just never recorded the last time we was out here.
Man, you got to leave a stop for?
No. Mo made a friend already.
I don't know his name.
Mo walked up in the building, and a dude said, "Arigato gozaimasu."
And I was like,
"He's like, I'm not Japanese."
Yeah, to be honest,
he's like, "Oh my bad, bro. I'm not racist or anything." But it was pretty funny.
I wasn't offended, but I did.
Nah, you don't get offended easily. Mm-hmm. All right, so we see you when we see you. You don't know where we off to next.
Mm-hmm.
It's a mystery. It's a serious trip, but it's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Shout out to you guys.
Mm-hmm.
For sticking around with us as you come along with us on this journey. Let go.
Alright, babe, by now, should we just tell them or
no.
should we wait? Oh, man. Alright, sorry guys. I tried, but I guess we're gonna have to wait. Ooh, we just picked up some bacon, egg, and cheese.
From the bodega.
At the where?
The bodega.
Just to go to the bodega. Here's Cairo with Gigi.
Hi. Hey, Papa.
He's happy. All right, babe, I gotta go to the bathroom. But you gotta... you got our life bag.
Okay?
Guard it.
We got the bro. Mo. About to get going. See you when we land. Let's take flight. I tell myself that I was gonna be lucky. Calling girls here, daddy no land. I'm move little guests, get the puppy and take them down low. I don't deal with them, I don't deal with them, I don't deal with them. But that's roll, I don't.
Alright guys.
Hey.
So we finally made it. As you guys can see, it's Barbados. First time in Barbados.
For me.
How many times have you been to Barbados?
A lot.
Yeah. Well, her father's in Barbados, so that's what we're here for. We're here to visit my father-in-law.
Yeah, we're here to see my dad. I haven't seen him in 2 years due to COVID.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not really able to fly right now, medical reasons why. So, I decided to take emergency leave and fly here, spend some time with him. So, Mo has joined me, hence why my mom came to stay with Cairo.
Yes.
But yeah.
So we actually came here with my brother-in-law, Mel's brother. But we had a lot of complications at the arrival of the airport in Barbados.
So essentially, me and my brother and Mo came down here to see my dad, and we all made sure to get vaccinated and tested negative to come down here, which were the rules on the site. When my brother got here, upon arrival, they pretty much said that he needed to be 14 days after vaccination in order to be considered fully vaccinated. And the quarantine time was 5 days. We're not here that long, so that pretty much threw the entire trip for him.
That was literally the entire trip, us being here for like five, six days. Yeah.
Right. They were trying to say that being that we were all together, we would have to take the unvaccinated person status. It was just really confusing and honestly complicated, and it was extremely unfortunate that my brother couldn't be here to see our dad. So he ended up getting on the flight, the same flight that we came in on. He just returned back. He's heading back to the original location.
Yeah.
And it sucks, I'm not gonna lie. But I'm excited to see my dad. I'm excited for Mo to finally meet my dad.
Mm-hmm.
COVID, I know, has had a lot of complications with, you know, flying and things like that. So I definitely needed to come out here to see my dad.
So yeah, like with COVID internationally, I feel like it's so hard to figure out like that right answer. Not a lot of people are on the same page, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, but
like a clear-cut protocol.
We're gonna still try to do what we came here to do, and that is to visit my father-in-law, her father, and take care of him. But but that's that.
I'm excited to show him Barbados. And shout out to the person who did our COVID
test. Yeah.
They were like, well, we had our mask on, and she was like, are y'all bloggers? I recognize y'all. Like, whoa, guess we're international now.
Mr. Worldwide.
International war.
But shout out to everybody.
But thank you.
Who continues to support us.
Yes, thank you for the people that actually, you know, when we that recognizes us and comes up and, you know, says hi. I feel like that's really dope. Does make our day. At the moment, we might be shy too, but it really does make our day.
I'm really friendly.
She's mega shy. But Melon Mode does Barbados. Alright guys, so it is only right that I still give you guys a room tour of where we're staying. So we are staying at the Cranes Hotel. So from the beginning, as we walk in, a nice little map. What is this? The map of the Caribbean Sea. We have the bathroom on our left. Little his and hers with the toilet room, tub, the shower. I think this is just the closet, and we have a nice little kitchen for us. We walk into the bedroom. Very cozy. Very cozy vibes. Out to the patio where we were.
Right now.
But yeah, we're only gonna be here for, while we wait for the COVID result for about 2 days before we leave. So it's a nice little cozy spot. Again, still can't get the thought that like, dang, it would've been real nice for all of us, basically me, Mel, and my brother-in-law, Dwayne, to all have been over here and spent time together, as well as visit dad together.
That is a beautiful cat. I will name him Bim.
Come here, Bim.
Well, first of all, you guys, we are at L'Azur to have our first food.
First meal?
Oh, first meal in Barbados. It's a very fancy place here. Food came out. Presentation is on point here.
Cajun salmon with asparagus.
Asparagus and mashed potatoes.
Look at the drizzle on the side. Presentation is cute, Barbados. Y'all got that.
That's what she's telling me. She said Bajan people can cook.
Sure can.
Man. Heavenly Father, thank you for this gathering. Thank you for allowing us to stay high to our destination, Lord. May you just bless the hands that have prepared this meal. May you strip away any impurities from this meal. May you bless us with nourishment, Lord. May this fill us and may it be good to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yo, this made me so happy. It's like, no joke. This food is amazing. Yeah, I'm gonna give Mel a little bit of the sweet potato. Never tasted sweet potato taste like this.
Hitting.
So good. Mm-hmm. I need you to empty out your mouth, babe. I need a full gargle it with the water a little bit.
Baby Odin.
Okay, but just drink some water, please. I'm just making her drink water. She doesn't drink water. Anyway. This food. Not even joking.
I thought they drizzled some sugar on.
I never tasted really sweet good. Potato taste like this. Wow, Barbados?
Dang.
Y'all got it.
What are you doing, babe?
So, the hair, I went back curly for this trip. So, what I do is, my trick, I put some water in a bottle mixed with argan oil conditioner in a spray bottle.
Mm-hmm.
And I literally spray my hair, walk my seat, get a nice good flow going, and I'm gonna leave it braided.
Can you just sleep like that?
This is like one of the easiest styles ever, but sometimes it's a little tedious, but I love this style.
Mm.
I haven't had it in 2 years. So I felt like, what better style to have for, you know, a trade? So then, like the curly weave look. Yeah, so I hope to meet some people out here and interact, you know, that'd be super dope. But I'm so excited to show Barbados from old guys. This is gonna be so fun.
Official day one in the Bim. Such a beautiful island.
First official day one in Barbados. We just got the results back that we got negative, so we gotta change all these blue bands to green. I think we get rid of one of the blue ones, so we'll be able to go out.
Is it this way?
Go out town. Yeah, it is this way. So we'll see what the day takes us.
Gang.
But first, breakfast.
Lego, I'm starving. Thank you.
Cheese, free.
At this one, you have full access to resort.
Yeah. It's like a huge mansion. Oh my gosh. It is true. They say that Barbados has one of the most beautiful beaches in the world. Here it is, guys.
Breakfast of the Champs. I just can't get over the fact how beautiful this place is. My goodness. Wow.
Oh my god, babe. I mean, look at this place. It's like an enchanted mansion. Yo, wait, dude.
Yeah.
I know. I know. But it was for you.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, how's it going? Just met one of our fellow YouTuber here.
Thank you so much for watching
us. I'm a YouTuber, but I like to watch.
Mm-hmm. You like to watch it? Thank you. I really appreciate it.
So we're going to tell my daughter.
You guys.
Oh, really?
First time Barbados.
First time for me.
Okay.
You're such a diva. Hey, Chang Mo. Hey, Mo.
What's up, babe?
How you doing today?
You know what I'm saying? I have these sunglasses on. And I know I need it, you know what I mean, to protect our eyes. But, yo, like, I also want to take in every, like, everything.
How
ketchup
does it
tastes
feel?
Ketchup tastes different. Tap water tastes different. Man, Caribbean? Wow. Caribbean's definitely going to be my go-to answer for vacation. Dream vacation, Caribbean.
Hold on,
okay.
Guys.
You know?
Can't
by the time we get on the plane to head back to New York, I'm gonna have a little accent.
Let me hear how you're gonna sound.
So you get the water. Yeah?
Babe, that is definitely water, that is definitely
and
UK.
You put the lime. You put the lime in the coconut.
No, babe. You sound
you put the lime.
Hi, I'm Anna. We're from Michigan. Oh, my girl. She's the best.
Lit.
So good to see you. Oh, my God.
I know, right? It's been so long.
Insane.
Hey, Mr. King. What's going on?
Out to hit the beach. Take you guys with us.
What you feel like eating today?
I feel like anything, because I heard the cream, their restaurants are really good. Whatever we eat, I am sure they are not gonna disappoint. Just put the water in the lime.
Babe, what do you be saying?
Put the water in the lime.
Hey, how you put water in lime? How you doing?
Sorry.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know. What's up? What are you talking about? He loves it here.
I love it.
Just like anywhere else.
I love it.
Where I'm at.
I love it.
He loves it here.
So you gotta speak in your Bajan accent. It's in you, babe.
I don't have
it. It is in you.
I don't have the Bajan accent good yet. Although I am partially Bajan. I need to rep that more because y'all only think I'm Trini. But I'm Trini and Bajan. I don't think I have the accent good yet. The only thing I can say is, you know, Trinis and Bajans don't like each other. They put a line in the sea over, and they're fighting over flying fish.
They're fighting over flying fish.
My
Bajans don't like Trinis. And Trinis don't like bitches either. The draw a line in the ocean over flying fish. But that's a different thing.
Welcome to the resort pool. Oh my gosh. My gosh. This is level one. Let's go to level two. Oh yeah, this will be it. Yep, right here. It's gonna be our spot.
So this is the other side of the pool. Yo, this resort is amazing. Speechless. How beautiful this place is. Make the thing go boom, boom. Alright guys, so bear with us because I know that this vlog might be all over the place, but I'm just gonna show you guys as much as we can. But I am aware that this might look like we're all over the place.
It's all over hot. Let me just say this.
Crazy moment, Mo thinks he's a fish. I swear he does. Look at my son, guys.
Who's your son?
You.
Come.
Mommy took you out.
Come.
Let me see. How deep is this water, sir?
It's only 4 feet.
Everywhere?
Yeah.
Okay, just enough for me to walk around.
Just right by your neck.
I'm 5'5", sir.
Okay. So, it's water time. How you enjoying
it? It's good. Since yesterday, it's been feeling like there's something missing. You know what I mean? And I'm like, yo, what is it? Like, this place is freaking amazing. Good time, but I think it's because Cairo's not here. Like,
big facts. I've been calling my child way too much. Can't help it, though. Like, what do you do when your child's not with you?
Summertime.
Summertime in September.
I will miss you. We'll bring you back. Your fifth birthday, we will bring you back.
Maybe fourth.
What's like a number that Barbados is known for? Like in China, eight is like their favorite number. Like, is there like a number? And there's no number? Alright, we'll make it five.
Damn, guys, this feels good. It's very much needed.
Alright, guys, so I'm gonna be hitting Barbados' first beach. My first Barbados experience. Alright, so there is the elevator or the stairs. Let me see how it says though. They don't say we go down the stairs.
Nope. It's a
no for me. Well, I'll meet you downstairs.
Okay, later.
This man, we on the sixth floor. He wanted to take the steps. See you when I get there, bud. See you when I get there. He is back. What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
I just didn't want to leave you.
You didn't want to leave me or it was a lot of steps?
No, I just didn't want to.
How you
How's
doing?
It going?
Like I said, see you on the bottom, brother.
I'll see you when I see ya.
But clearly, he's back, guys. Yes. Yes, he didn't want to stay. He didn't want to use all those stairs by himself. He wanted to climb all these steps. Y'all look at this. It's a no for me.
All right, the moment that I have been waiting for. Barbados Beach. That Mel keeps saying Barbados has the best beach in the world. First off, very impressed by the intro walk.
Know that.
Wow. I mean, wow.
Come on, babe, I'm hungry, let's go.
I'm ready. This is... Can I get our fan pass?
A fan pass?
You said I should've used this at the airport. Now, if I want to talk Beijing, I'll say something like, you can get our fan pass? That is an error.
That is an error.
That is an error right there.
That is an error right there.
I think my father would be extremely disappointed with my Beijing accent. Extremely. When I was younger, and I used to do cartwheels in my father's house, he said, hey, cut that now. I don't want you skinning cuffins in my house.
What? Say it again.
He used to say, hey, Miss Lady, cut that now.
Cut that now.
I don't want you skinning cuffins in my house.
Hey, are you skinning cuffins in my house? What does that mean?
That's a, he's like, hey, Miss Lady, cut that now. Stop skinning cuffins in my house. That means to do a cartwheel.
And our dinner begins. This is the spaghetti carbonara. That's a lovely lady. That's a lasagna. Taste test. I'm gonna take that as a yes.
They just don't disappoint.
They don't, man. Alright, so I'm gonna try lasagna. Hot?
Yeah, a little bit.
That's impressive. All the potatoes.
Ah. So you just taste all the ingredients.
That potato is fresh. All right, time to try mine. What did they say? Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
That French. Ciao. That's good.
I bet it is.
But I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna be honest. The one in Vegas was a little better.
You got the same thing?
Oh, I got the same thing. The one in Vegas was better though. I'll be honest.
Yeah, you don't know that. Mm-hmm.
So this is the moonlight next to this Hampton-like pool.
Hey babe. How was dinner?
Dinner was good. luckily we got some food left over because yesterday I was okay, but then apparently Mel was like hungry that she had to.
I forced myself to go to sleep so that my hunger wouldn't take over. You look good. Check you out. You vacation ready, babe. Let me see. Let me see. Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, Tom.
It's easy.
Something light.
It's easy. Easy.
You got a girlfriend?
I got a wife.
Well, tell her she's a blessed woman.
Oh, this is a quiet zone.
Well, tell her she's a blessed woman. Thank you. I gotta see the struggle I gotta do for Mo to take a picture. Yeah, that's it. Let me see the shirt, Mom.
He said, I'm the boss until mommy comes back.
Why does your stomach look so big, Cairo?
Oh my god.
Because he's just been eating.
Wow, you
he's
like...
hungry.
Hi, why is the middle of your head? Your grandmother gave you this George Jefferson style. I wrote shark. I miss you, man.
I know, we saw a baby your size and we were like,
I saw a little baby, I'm like, man.
Well, your size, but older.
Yeah, I was about to say, not your age, your size though. They were definitely older than you.
So, we just came back from dinner at D'Onofrio's on a resort. So tomorrow's the day where I actually go see my dad. The reason I'm here for this trip.
Yes.
So I know people probably are like, why haven't y'all ever saw my dad or anything like that? It's because he's been living in Barbados for like the last five or six years. He moved from New York after he retired from being a principal. He moved from New York and he came back to Barbados where he's from to retire. A couple of years ago, my dad got diagnosed with dementia and Parkinson's. So that's been like extremely rough. I never talk about it. And damn, this is hard. Shoot. So it's progressively have gotten worse. He recently got diagnosed with prostate cancer last year. So COVID, everything happened. I wasn't able to fly out to see him, and then I just got approved emergency leave to come see him now. So I have been dealing with that. I'm consistently praying and asking God to heal my dad, but yeah. So anyone who's had to deal with a parent or a loved one who has like dementia or anything like that probably can understand what it's like, I guess. But that's like a part of my life that I don't ever really like to,
of course,
bring up. But I don't know what to expect. I haven't seen him like physically in 2 years. 2019 was the last time I physically saw him, when he was in New York. I flew down there to see him when he flew in to get a checkup. But he's unable to fly or do anything like that. So we're here. And pretty much just trying to brace myself for the reality of the situation. I'm still praying and I'm still believing that God's a healer. But I needed to make sure that we saw him. I couldn't let any more time pass. Whew.
Yeah, so we'll be out of our quarantine stage tomorrow, where we'll finally be able to go and visit my father-in-law. The reason why we're actually in Barbados, you know, we just really wanted to give you guys a heads up before tomorrow, just because it's very private, and although we do want to share.
It's gonna be very tough. Hence why I was like, super sad that my brother couldn't be here with me. So this is a tough one. So I appreciate all the prayers. Today's actually his birthday. I thought we'd be like, I'd be able to go see him and stuff for his birthday, but I'm just thanking God that he has another birthday. Man, this is tough. You want to be real as possible on YouTube. This is like a part of my life I never thought I would like
share.
Yeah,
so again, although we want to share as much as with you guys, you know, it's a private situation too, so please
just understand if we just don't know what, you know what I mean? We might not just want to record.
Just wanted to give you guys a heads up because I don't want it to look like we're just out here having a grand vacation. It's the reason why I'm out here. But shout out to the people who do know the situation and have continuously kept my dad in their prayers. I really appreciate it. But we shall see what tomorrow brings. Bracing myself for whatever is to come. But happy birthday, Daddy.
Happy birthday.
If you ever see it. Happy birthday. I love you. That's what goes on. I'm a high people. I always wondered where my dad was, but he's currently bedridden, so we had to get on this flight. That's that. Let's see what tomorrow brings. I'm good.
1, 2, 3, 4. Next week to the Mel and Mo Show.